Good morning, St. Francis. It is Friday, April the 2nd, 2021. It is Good Friday. Coming to you from another location because I am in New Bern, because last night Bishop and I celebrated the Mass of the Lord's Supper with the people of Annunciation Parish in Havelock. So one of the benefits is that you get to spend the night because it's a distance from Raleigh. So wake up this morning in New Bern, making the way back to Raleigh to celebrate the celebration of the Lord's Passion at the cathedral at 3 p.m. But today, Good Friday, and what are we celebrating? We are celebrating not the death of an individual. We are celebrating an act of great love, an act of great love that overpowers the hatred, the anxieties, the pain, the torment, the frustrations, the hopelessness, the despair of humanity. That is what it does, and that is the heart of what it does. Again, to just mourn the death of Jesus is not to understand the great impact and the great resolution that this death on the cross offers for us. Again, the movement from death to life is always the movement in the life of a Christian. It's a life in which we are to see hope in the midst of despair, in which we are to see victory in the midst of suffering. It's when we are able to see the achievements that await and what that we yearn for in the midst of everything that seems to stand in the way of them. God's will never be frustrated, no matter how much we may put in its way, no matter how much we may do otherwise, no matter how much we may think that our way is the best way, or that our way can do better than God. God's plan for us, for creation, for everything that exists, will never, ever be frustrated, because God is the one who keeps us embraced in love. God is the one who tries to show us again and again, and who is determined to show us again and again, the power of love in our life, and what it means to be a people who can hope because of love, who can live because of love, who can become all that we are meant to be in this world simply because of love. As we pass through the second day of the sacred Paschal Triduum, may we be ever more attuned to the power of love in our lives that not only conquers death, but allows us to grow in relationship with each other and to embrace who and what we are for the greater glory of God. May the Lord give you peace.